in heaven,
still in touch with you in the living arms. You three, Barone, Tulane, and Longville, have sworn to live with me 3 years to earn my fellow scholars and keep these statutes recorded in this schedule here. Your oaths are passed, and so subscribe to me.
I am resolved. 'Tis but a 3 years pass. The mind shall banquet, though the body pine.
My loving lord, Tulane, is mortified. To love, to wealth, to pomp, I pine and die with all these living in philosophy.
I can't even say their protestation of so much of the liege I've already sworn to live and study here for 3 years. But there are other strict observances, as not to see woman within that term, which I hope well is not your order. And then, to in 1 day a week to touch no food, and but one meal of every day beside, the which I hope well is not your order. And then, to sleep but 3 hours in the night, and not to be sick to weep of all the day, which I hope well is not your order. Oh, these are barren tasks, too hard to keep, not to see ladies, study fast, not sleep.
Your oath is passed, and pass away from me.
No, then, if you please, my liege, I only swore to stay here with your grace and study in your court in your space.
You swore that, Rome, and the rest.
By yea and nay, sir, then I swore in jest. What is the end of study? Let me know.
Why ask no tells we should not know?
Come on, then. I will swear to study, sir, to know the thing I am forbid to know, as thus to study where I well may die, and where to feast I am expressly forbid. Where to meet from some mistress fine, where mistresses from common sense are hidden.
These be the stops that hinder study quite, betray our intellects, the vain delight.
Why, all delights are vain, but that most vain, with pain purchased, doth inherit pain. As pain flee to pour upon a book, to seek the light of truth, while truth the while does falsely blind the eyesight of the soul, who dazzling so that I shall be as he. Study is like the heaven's glorious sun, that will not be deep searched with saucy looks, for small continual plunders e'er won, save base authority from others' books. These earthly godfathers that give a name to every fixed star have no more profit on their shining nights than those who walk and know not what they are. Too much to know is to not know but fame, and every godfather can give a name.
How well he's read to reason against reading.
Proceeding well to stop all good proceeds.
He weeds the corn, yet still lets grow the weeding.
Well, say that I am. Why should proud summer boast before the birds that weeding causes to sing? But that in each thing season grows. So you to now study is too late. So climb o'er the house and then lock the little gate.
Then sit you out, bro. Go home. At you.
Nay, my lord, I have swore to study with you. And though I abhor more than barbarism, and that angel knowledge can say, spoken more than read, I will, by the penance of each 3 years say, so let me read, if you'll let me read the name into the strictest degrees, I'll write my name. I tell you that no woman shall come within a mile of my court at this big reclaim. 4 days ago, let's see the penalty. On pain of losing her tongue. Who devised this penalty?
Mary, that did I.
Sweet lord.
And why? This is the dread penalty.
A dangerous law against gentility. I tell that no woman shall be, that no man shall be seen to be taught to speak with a woman within the term of 3 years, or he shall endure such public shame as the rest of the court can possibly devise. This article, my liege, yourself must break. Well, you know, here comes an embassy, the great French king's daughter, with yourself to speak, a maid of grace and complete majesty, about to surrender a adjutant to her decrepit, sick and bedridden father. Therefore, my liege, this article is made in vain, or vainly comes in my princess hither.
What say you, lords? Why, this was quite forgot.
So study evermore is overshot. While study doth do the thing it would, it doth forget to do the thing it should.
We must, of course, dispense with this decree. She must, of course, lie here on your necessity.
Necessity will make this war sworn 3,000 times within 3 years. But if I break faith, this word shall speak for me. I am forsworn on mere necessity. So
illustrious wight, a man of fire and words, fashion his own knight. Cost our dismay, shall be ours, for, and so to study these 3 years is but short.
Which is the Duke's own person?
This fellow, what was?
I myself reprehend his own person, for I was Grace's thoroughbred, which I will see his own person in flesh and blood.
This is he.
Senor, on me convention, this villainy, this letter will tell you all.
Sir, the contempt thereof, for as touching as me.
How low, sir, of the matter? I hope for higher words.
A high hope for a low heaven.
To hear or forbear laughing.
To hear meekly, sir, and to laugh moderately, or to remember.
Well, be as that is, be it as the style shall give cause to climb the merriness.
The matter is to me, sir, as concerning Jaconetta. The manner of it is, I was taken with the manner.
In what manner?
The manner of the following, sir, all those 3. I was seen with her in the manor house, sitting with her upon the floor, and taken following her into the park, which put together is a manner of the following, sir. Now, sir, for the manner. It is the manner of a man to speak to a woman, for the form, in some form.
For the form following, sir?
As it shall fall in my correction, and heaven been the right.
Will you hear this letter with attention?
As you would hear it before.
Such is the simplicity of flesh, the heart of man.
Great Dick, the welcome spicer, the sole dominator of the law.
Not a word of cost her yet.
So it is.
So it may be, but if he says it is so, he isn't really true. And so.
Peace.
Beat him if you mean, every man dares not fight.
Not a word.
Of other men's secrets, I must.
So it is, and we see it. The single colored melancholy. I took myself to her, and there did I see that low spirited swain, that base mirror of thine her.
Me?
That unlettered, small knowing soul.
Me?
That shallow vassal.
Still me.
As I remember, cost her height.
Oh, me.
Sort in consort, against thy salvageable thing, the incontinent, can it live? Oh, with. And I pass to say, but wherewith?
With a witch.
With a child of our grandmother Eve, a female of thy more sweet understanding, a woman. He is my ever-esteemed youth, quick to me, has sent to me to receive the meed of punishment by thy sweet greatest officer, Anthony Gilbert, a man of good carriage, merit, and beauty, and excavation.
The aunt shall please you. I am Anthony Gilbert.
And as for Jaconetta, was always to be the vessel of all, which I apprehended the woman to swain. Her I keep as a vessel of the law's gift, and that thy sweet slightest purpose shall bring her to me. Thine in all confidence, a lovely, devoted heart, where we each to be signed. Don Andrea, ti amo.
Thank you. No. No. Oh, Lord. Sir, no.
How canst thou pardon? He saved me, saved many. My tender, shoot.
By a familiar demonstration of the workings, my tough senor.
Why tough, senor? Why tough, senor?
Why tender juvenile? Why tender juvenile?
I spoke. Tender juvenile. Ever think of thy young days, which we, mingle, tender.
And I, tough senor, as an impression entitled to your old time, which we, made it tough.
I love not to be crossed.
He speaks the mere contrary. Crosses love, not him.
I hate promise to stop. With him.
You may do it in an hour, sir.
Impossible.
How many is one Christ sold?
I hear his reckoning. It feeds the spirit of a tempster.
You are a gentleman and a gangster, sir.
I confess to both. They are both the varnish of a complete man. The dwarf hit a very wrong into the base. Where? Pursue, which is base. regarding the hawk, if I love. In how can I be love? Which is false thing? Love is a familiar. Love is a devil. There is no evil angel but love. It sends him for something, and he has an excellent strength. How do I? Be still, run, for your manager is in love. Yes, you know it. Is this so extreme horror part of the crime? For I am sure I suffer from it.
father doth hear the king of 100,000 crowns, yet there remains unpaid 100,000 more. In surety of the Bishop of Court of Aquitaine is bound to us. Now, if the king, your father, would just fulfill one part of that half which remains unsatisfied, we would give up our right in Aquitaine and hold fair friendship with his majesty. But that it seems he little purposes, for here he doth demand to have repaid 100,000 crowns and to have his title upon Aquitaine. Now, were his request not so far from reason to you, your fair self should make a yielding up against some reason in my place, and go home well satisfied with France against
you. You do the king, my father, too much wrong, and so wrong the reputation of your name, and so unseemly to confess receipt of that which hath so faithfully been paid.
I do protest, I never heard of it, and if you prove it, I'll take you back, or you'll have back with it.
We arrest your word. Point at you can produce such acquittances for such a sum of special offices of Charles' father. Good madam, the packet did not come when that and other special offices are bound. Tomorrow, shall have a sign.
It shall suffice me, and which interview I will yield to all the full reason. In the meantime, receive such love from my hand, as honor without breach of honor may make tender unto thy true worthiness. You may not, fair princess, come in my gates, but here without you shall be received, as you shall deem yourself lodged in my heart. Though denied fair hall within my house. Your own good thoughts excuse me, and so farewell. Tomorrow we shall visit you again.
Sweet health and fair desires consult your grace.
Thy own wish, which I deem every place.
Lady, I would commend you to mine own heart.
Pray, do my commendations. I would be glad to see it.
Oh, we can hear its groan.
Is the fool sick?
Sick at the heart.
Come to our pavilion. Boyetta is disposed. I am longing to make a mouth of his eye by adding a tongue which I know would not lie.
Thou art an old lovemonger and speakest skillfully. She is Cupid's grandmother and loves music. There was Venus like her mother.
purchase this experience.
My opinion, my observation.
Treachery, sir. I must employ you. He must have an
act. Mr. Dislet, sir.
Demeaning with the ingenious is not laid in metal in heavy gold in stock.
Many an honest master. Or rather, master, no.
I say that is slow.
You are too swift to say so. Is lead slow that is which fired from a gun?
Sweet small rhetoric. Here goes me, a cat. The poor at the feet. I shoot at this way.
Thump, and then I flee.
No!
one of the sonnets already. The clown words the fool sentence, and the lady hath the sweet clown, sweeter fool, sweetest lady. By earth, I would not care a pin if the other three were in. Oh, here comes one now, the white papers. God give you grace to grow.
I be
shot by heaven. Proceed, sweet Cupid, thou hast shot him with thy bird bolt under the left hat. In fate, secrets.
So sweet a kiss, the golden sun is not. The breath only drop upon the road. As thine eye beam, their breath raised the smoke, and that is dew upon my cheeks down flow. No drop as a coach doth carry thee, and so ridest thou triumphing in my woe. Do with thee all the tears that well in me, and they thy glory to my grief will show. O queen of queens, how is thou itself? No thought can think, nor tongue mortal tell. How can she know my pain? I'll drop the paper. But, sweet leaves, shade folly, with see that comes here. Long the bill and reading, listen, dear.
Ah, me, I am forsworn. Is it like a Persian wearing papers? Am I the first to have been perjured so?
I could have been comforted. Nay, not by the two that I know. Thou makest the truth brief, the corner cap of society, the shape of love's tiber that hangs up simplicity.
I fear these stubborn lines like the power to move. Oh, sweet Maria, empress of my love, these saints shall I tear and write in prose.
Oh, rhymes are guards of one should keep its toes disfigured on his spot.
This same shall go. Did not the heavenly rhetoric of mine eye, against whom the world cannot hold argument, persuade my heart this also? Vows broken for thee deserve not punishment. A woman I forswore, but this I shall prove. Thou, being a goddess, I forswore not thee. My vow was earthly, thy love heavenly. Thy grace been gained cures all disgrace in me. Oaths are but breath, and breath a vapor is. Then, thou, fair sun on which my earth doth shine, exhalest this vapor vow. It is thine. If broken, then, it is no fault of mine, if by me broke. What fool is not so wise, to lose an oath, to gain a paradise?
Why, this is liver vain, which makes flesh a deity. A pretty goose of goddess, pure, pure idolatry. Oh, Godwin, Scotland, for we are much out of the way.
By whom shall I send this? Company, stay!
all hidden, old infant slave, sit here in the sky like a demigod, and watch wretched cool sympathy for your eye. Oh, Saxon of the mill, by heaven, I have my mission. Do main transport, Warwick Johnson,
it is. Oh, goodbye!
Oh,
in this bush, and I have marked your throat. Before you both do, I blush.
I've heard your guilty lies. I observed your passions.
When sighs weep for you, they know well your passions. I mean, says one, by Jove, the other cries, one her hair golden, crystal the other's eyes. You, would to gain paradise break faith and troth? And what will Rome say when that he shall hear? Faith so great, with such zeal did sway, how you will scorn the spin his way, think back and try it. Now for all the love I see, I would rather know you both by now.
Now step by horse to the car. Ah, my good liege, pray me pardon. Good part, what grace hast thou to prove these worms for loving so that art goes in love? Your eyes do make no flinches. Your tears there is no certain princess that appears. You love me, Persia, 'tis a hateful thing. Touch me, none but minstrels like a son. But are you not ashamed? Nay, are not all three of you to be much more shot? Your moment is your king's, your moment may see, but I mean to find in each of three. Oh, it's scenes of foolery I have seen, sighs and groans of sorrow in a teen. Oh, me, with what patience have I sat to see a king transformed to a gnat, to see great Hercules whipping a gig and profound Solomon to tune a jig. And where lies thy grief? Oh, tell me, good Dumaine. And gentle Longueville, where lies thy king? And my witches, all about the rest. A cockle, oh!
Too bitter as thy jest, are we thus betrayed to die over you?
Not you to me, sir, but I betrayed by you! I bet him honest! I bet hold it sin to break the vow. I'm engaged and I betray! By keeping company with men, like men of inconsistency. Oh, when shall you meet, see me writing a thing in rhyme? A groan for love, or spend a minute's time in pruning me? When shall you hear that I will raise a hand, a foot, a face, and an eye?
Soft, put them away so fast, the true men are a thing together, so.
I put from love, good lover, so let me go.
God bless the king.
What present hast thou here?
So certain treason.
What makes you?
Nay, sir, it makes nothing.
Ah, hey then, think why nothing either, treason, and you go away in peace together.
Show his face, young blood doth not obey. And why
what did these red lines show some love of mine?
Doth you, quoth he, who sees the heavenly Rosaline that is blinded by the heaven of her brow?
What zeal, nay, what fury doth inspire me now? I love her mistress as a gracious mood. She is an attending star, scarce seen a light.
My eyes are then no eyes, nor I grown by love day return to night. And beauty doth varnish the new age. Oh, tis the sun that makes all things shine.
But what of this? Are we not all in love?
Not so ever. Thereby we are all forsworn.
Then leave this chapter, girl. Prove our loving law and our faith not torn.
Oh, some authority, how to proceed? Some trick? Some pulling? How does she do that?
I know it there. Some flattery for this evil.
Tis more than need. Have asked you affection as men at arms? Consider what you did first swear unto to fast, to study, to see no ladies. Tis flash treason against the kingly state of youth. Say, can you fast? Your stomachs are too weak in abstinence and generous maladies. And where have you vowed to study, my lords, since each of you have forsworn his book? Can you still dream and pore? And thereon look. And where have you, my lord, or you have found the ground of study's excellence without the beauty of a woman's face? For where is any author in the world that can teach such beauty as a woman's face? From the woman's eyes, this doctrine I derive, they light, the still light for me being fine. They are the books, the arts, the academies that show, contain, and nourish all the world. For love's sake, a word that loves all men, for men's sake, the authorities of these women, or women's sake, by whom we men are men. Let us once break our oaths to lose ourselves, or else we lose ourselves to keep our oaths. Is it religion for us to be much more sworn? For it is charity that fulfills the law, and who can sever love from charity?
Saint Cupid, then, and soldiers to the field.
Advance your staff into the crumbling walls.
Now then, on to plain dealing. Ladies, most of five. Shall we resolve to woo these mills of France?
Aye, women too. Therefore, let us devise some entertainment for them.
First, let us conduct them hither to the park. Then, no word, every man takes the hand of his fair mistress. In the afternoon, we will, with some pastime solace, entertain them. With merriment, dances, masks, and merry hours, we are all now forsworn and assure her with flowers.
Yeah.
Truman.
Knife of one thing in the world, thou shouldst have to buy gingerbread. Oh, there's the very remuneration I have, thy master. Thou half-pity purse of wit, thou pigeon egg of discretion.
Hutchman, bring your it. We will be single from the
Do you want to enter in view at the charge house from the top of the mountain?
Or Mont Hill.
And yours with pleasure for at the mountain.
I do, sad question.
Mary, it is the king's most pleasure of affection to congratulate the princess of Rivera in the posteriors of this day,
which the ruled multitude do call the afternoon.
Posterior of this day, most generous sir, is liable, congruent and measurable for the afternoon. The word is above all, too sweet and apt. I do assure you, sir, I do assure you.
Mary, the king is a noble gentleman in my I do assure very good friend, for what is in your between us, let it pass. I beseech you, remember, I beseech you, a burden, and among other important and most serious designs, ain't of great importance to you, but let it pass. For, I must tell thee some certain special honors, it pleases his greatness to impart to our mother. He's not a man of travel, as yet seen in the world. But let it pass. For the very old of all is but sweetheart. I do him for a secrecy. The king would have me present the princess, sweet child, with some delightful ostentation or show or pageant or antique or fine. Now, understanding that the curate and yourself are good at such eruptions and breaking out of Mars and the world, I have been acquainted you with all to the end, to crave
your assistance.
Sir, you shall present before her the nine worthies. Sir, as concerning some entertainment of time, some show in the posterior of this day, to be rendered by our assistants at the command of the king, this most gallant, illustrate, and learned gentleman. Before the princess, I see none so fit as to present the nine worthies. Where will you find men worthy enough to present them? Joshua, yourself. Myself, this most gallant gentleman. This swain, because of his great limb, shall pass as Pompey the Great, the page, Hercules.
Pardon me. He is not quantity enough for that. What is he for? He is not so big as the end of his life.
Shall I have audience? He shall present Hercules in my lordship. His enter and exit shall be strangling a snake. For this, I will call an apology.
An excellent device. So if any of the audience hiss, you may cry, well done, Hercules! Now crushes the snake! That is the way to make an offense. Gracious. Though, you will have the grace to do it.
For the rest, though, you are it.
I will play for you myself.
Thrice worthy gentlemen.
Shall we do
evening?
We attend.
We will live, if please.
vows to do as such flowers do. Thou sacred bright moon, and quickly start shining with the removal of the clouds upon our watery tide. Not measure to a thousand, one chain. Now bids me then, cease begging his ghost drink.
Play music then, nay, you must do it soon. Not yet, no dance, thus cheaper.
You do not dance, how comes with us a stranger?
You took the moon at full, but now she's changed.
Ay, and she is still the moon, and I a man. You should play, I'll say so. What's your truth?
Beautiful. God save you, madam. Where's the princess?
Gone to her tent. So please, your majesty, can I be any service to my mother?
That you'd outfit the audience for one word.
I do, and so is she.
No, my lord.
This lady pecks of wit and pigeon, please. And utters a name of God, please. She's wet, she's wit's peddler. And she'll tell her wares at may wakes, whistles, meetings, markets, and fairs. True of her eighth form, Mademoiselle the Nurse, when she plays at tables, chives with dice, to show her teeth as white as whalebone, and to do with honey-tongued boyette.
Bless her on his tongue, by my heart, that puts to your mother's age out of his heart.
See what is there? Behavior, what art thou when this mad woman showed thee? And what art thou now?
All hail, fair madam, and fair time of day.
Fair in all hail is foul, as I conceive.
Construe my speech is better, if you may.
Then wish me better. I will give you leave.
We came to visit you, and purpose it now to lead you to our court. Vouchsafe it, then.
This field shall hold me, and so hold your vow. Nor God, nor I, delights in the jury of men.
Madam, rebuke me not that which you provoke. The virtue of your eye must break my own.
You nickname virtue, vice you should have spoke, for virtue's office never breaks men to troth. Now by my maiden honor, it is pure as the unsullied, I protest. A world of humors though I should endure, I would not yield to be your house's guest. So much I hate of breaking the cause to thee of heavenly oath, vowed with integrity.
For we live in desolation here, but seeing them visited. Much to our shame.
It is not so, my lord. It is not so, I swear. We have had pastimes and pleasant game. I'm not so Russian. One does but a blame.
No. Russian.
In truth, my lord, trim gowns full of courtship and of state.
My lord, it is not so. My lady, to the manner of days, in courtesy gives undeserving praise. We four, indeed, confronted were with four in Russian habit. Here they stayed an hour and talked apace. And in that hour, my lord, they did not bless us with one happy word. I dare not call them fools, but this I think. When they are thirsty, fools would fain have drink.
This just as dries me, fair, gentle, sweet. Your wit makes wise things foolish. When we reach with eyes best seeing, heaven's fire and eye, by light we lose light. Your capacities of that nature, of that huge store, that when wise things seem foolish and rich, but poor.
This proves you wise and rich, for in my eye.
I'm no fool, in full of poverty.
But that you take what doth to you belong, it were false to set words to my father.
Oh, I am yours and all that I possess.
All the fool mine.
I cannot give you less.
Which of the visitors was it that you wore?
Where? When? What? What visitors? What visitors?
There then, that wizard, that superfluous case that hid the worse and showed the better face.
You are described, though, Marcus, now downright.
Bear with me, I am sick. Right, Lord. Lord, have mercy on us on these three, for they are infected, and their heart it lies. They have caught the plague, have it their eyes. These lords are visited. You people, not us, or my lord's tokens, I don't see on you.
No, they are free that gave these tokens to us.
Our states are forbid, seek not to undo us.
It is not so, for how can this be true, that you stand forfeit, being those that sue?
Peace, I will have nothing to do with you.
Nor shall not, if I do as I intend.
Say what you will, my wit's at an end.
Teach us, sweet madam, proud through transgression, some fair excuse.
The fairest is confession. Were you not here, but even now disguised?
Madam, I was.
And were you well advised?
I was, madam.
When you then were here, what did you whisper in your lady's ear?
That more than all the world I did respect her.
When she shall counsel, you will reject her.
Upon my honor, no!
Peace, peace, forbear! Your oath once broke, you force not to forswear.
Despise me when I break this oath of mine!
I will! And therefore keep it. Rosamund, what did the Russian whisper in your ear?
Madam, he swore he did hold me dear as precious eyesight, and did value me above this world, adding thereto, moreover, that he would wed me, or else die, my lover.
God give thee joy of him, the noble lord most honorably doth unhold his word.
What mean you, lady, by my troth? I never swore that thing in such an oath.
By heaven you did, and to confirm it plain you gave me this. But take it, sir, again.
My faith is the princess I did give. I knew her by the jewel on her sleeve.
Pardon me, sir. This jewel was she with, and Lord Perone, I thank him, is my dear. What? Will you have me, or your
Neither I'll admit to twain. I see a trick on it, chuck upon it. Here's in conceit. Thus we are again forsworn. Thus you, to make us untrue, you put our page out, go to. You are allowed. Die when you will. Smock be your shroud. You be your body, do you? Eyes, I do see that wound like a leaden sword.
Who fairly hath this strange marriage
come here and run? Lo, she is tilting straight. Peace, I have done. Welcome to your wit, thou hardest and fair friend.
Oh, Lord, sir, they would know whether the free worthy shall come in or no.
What? Are they but free worthy?
No, sir, she bar finds every one of her sins free.
And three times thrice is none.
Not so, sir. Under correction, sir, I hope it's not so. You cannot beg us, sir. I can assure you. Sir, we know what we know. I hope, sir, that three times thrice, sir.
Is not now.
Under correction, sir, we know her until it's all come out.
By Jove, I always took three threes for nine.
It's more pity, sir, you should give you a living by reckoning.
How much is it?
Oh, Lord, sir. The parties themselves, the actors, will show where to slip off about. As for my own part, I am, as they say, but to perfect one man and one poor man. Hope beyond great, sir.
Art thou one of the worthies?
It pleased them to make me worthy, hope beyond, for my role. But I know not which grave the word. I understand for him.
Go to, bid them prepare.
We will turn and find the officer. We will take some care.
Rome, they will shame us. Let them not approach.
We are shame-proof, my lord. it is some policy to have one show worse than the king's company.
I say, they shall not come.
Nay, my good lord, let me your ruin now. That sport best pleases that doth least know how. Their zeal strives to content, and its contents die in the zeal of that which it presents. Their form confounded makes most foremen mirth. When great things laboring perish in their birth.
A great description of our sport, my lord.
You know you. So much of thy heroic place as well. Your grace of words.
Doth this man serve God?
Why ask you?
He speaks not like a man of God's making.
So Fortuna, de la Cueva. I wish the prince was worth talking
about. Here is like to be in the presence of the world. He presents Hector of Troy, the swain Poppy the Great, the parish curate Alessandro the Conqueror, the peer Judas Maccabeus. And if these four worthies in their first show thrive, then change their habits and present the other five.
There's five in the first show.
You want to see, if not so.
The pedant, the braggart, the hedge priest, the fool, and the boy.
After the ship has set sail, who should come to bed?
St. George's hat, she can approach.
I'm in approach.
They are whipped in Mars and places. They are mighty gay. That one. A gift.
A huge milk snake.
A lemon. Stop it, though.
No, Finn.
Peace. They are whipped in Mars and places. The petal, a gift. The air, a villain, a man so big that serpent you would fight. Yea, from morning to night, I'll be a villain. I am that flower.
That kind of man.
Sweet or like the ring at top.
I'm a static. Give it the rage. We're bronze against Hector.
The infected the greyhound.
The sweet wonder is dead and rotten. Be not the bond of very sweet child. For when he was alive, he was a man. But I will follow with my advice. Sweet woman, bestow on me these things so dear.
Speak, brave Hector. We are much delighted.
I do adore this sweet princess.
None, sir, not a foot.
He may not body your aunt.
This Hector, far, surmounted. Hurdle!
Naked and forlorn hermitage. Remote
mine, let our hands part. Neither the title of the other's heart.
If this were more than this, I would deny to fly about these powers of mine with rest. The sudden hand of death goes up my eye. If forever is my heart in my breath.
What to me, my love, what to me? A wife?
A peer? Fair health and honest. With three full love, I wish you all these three.
And may I say, I thank thee, gentle wife?
Not so, my lord. A 12 months and a day, and I'll mark no words that smooth face or say. Come with the king, doth to my lady come. Then, if I have much love, I'll give you some.
Now serve thee true and faithfully till then.
Yet, swear not, lest ye be put forth again.
What saith Maria?
As the 12 months said, I'll change my black gown for a faithful friend.
I will stay with patience, though the time is long.
To lie for you, you shall not are so young.
Studies, my lady, mistress. Look on me, behold the window of mine heart, mine eye. If you attend the suit, to find some answer of thine, notice there is imposed on me love.
Oft have I heard of you, my lord Barone, before I saw you, and the world's large tongue proclaims you for a man, replete with mocks, full of comparisons and wounding flouts, which you on all estates will execute. That lie within the mercy of your wit. To read this wormwood from your fruitful brain, and therewithal to win me, if you please, without the which I am not to be won. You shall this 12-month term, from day to day, visit the speechless sick, and still converse with groaning wretches. And your task shall be, with all the fierce endeavor of your wit, to enforce the pained impotent to smile.
To move wild laughter in the throat of death, it cannot be as impossible for mirth moves not soul in agony.
A just prosperity lies within the ear of him that hears it. Continue then, and I will have you, and that falls with all. But if they will not, throw away that spirit, and I will find you empty of that fault. Right joyful of your reformation.
12 months. Well, befall which will befall, I'll just a 12 month in a hospital.
Aye, sweet my lord, and so I take my leave.
No matter, we'll bring you on your way.
Our wooing doth not end like an old play. Jack hath not Jill, and the courtesy of these mistresses may have well made our sports to common.
Come, sir, it wants a 12 month and a day, and then to fill in.
That's too long for the play.
Thank you.
coming.